Hi guys, my name is Simeon and welcome to my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel, I usually talk about Sweden and as an international student to Sweden, I also talk about how more African students and international students can come to Sweden to study. So if you are a returning subscriber on my channel watching this video, thank you so much for watching my previous videos. Yeah, today we'll be talking about how I actually got my residence permit card, and we'll be going through my story of how I applied for mine and got mine. Then we'll also go through the website and look at a few things on the website because it can be a little bit confusing. So I'll explain a few things. And if you also have questions concerning what I'll be discussing about, you could, of course, drop it in the comment section below. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. So let's go. Yeah, of course, the first thing you have to do is, of course, apply for a school. Since you want to get a residence permit card for a school or for education, you actually have to first apply to a school. And when you've been given admission by the school, you actually get a email from the school that your admission has been confirmed and you can go ahead with getting your application started. So that is the first thing. Of course, the first thing would be to apply to the school. Number one, apply to the school and get an admission from the school. Number two is to go to migration vacet. Yeah, I think that's how it's pronounced. But yeah, it's short for the migration agency, or it's Swedish for migration agency. I suppose to go to migrationsvacet.se and start your process. So you actually see that on migration vacet there are so many links there to visit. Don't worry, just look for the one that concerns you. That's the one for education and for school. Another thing too that is great to mention is also the fact that so many people think that applying to Sweden, you are actually getting a visa, but you're actually getting a residence permit card, a card, and not a visa. So the card looks like this. This is my card. Yeah, this is my card. It's not really a visa, and you actually don't get, the only stamp you get on your passport is the one from the Nigerian Immigration Service that shows that you're living in Nigeria, and it shows the date you're living in Nigeria. So you don't get any visa stamp on your passport. You basically get just this card. Of course, you also have to show them your passport because they need the passport number when you're applying. So applied on the website. Actually got, so to apply, you need, the application fee is about 1,500 Swedish krona, which roughly translates to about 65-70k then. I think it was 65k I paid. 65,000 naira, yeah, sorry. 65,000 naira. And yeah, sorry. I'm actually looking at my book here, so sorry. 65,000 naira now. I think now it would be about maybe 75,000 naira to 80,000 naira because of the exchange rate. So that's something you should check out. But 65,000 naira, then you actually have to also show a proof of fund. So the proof of fund is something that I think people have issues with, and I've heard people message me. People have messaged me and asked if you know they have to keep the money for about 90 days, 120 days in the same account, and if they don't need to do that. And I'll say you don't need to. For me, for my application, what happened was I actually kept in the money that week, and when I applied, of course you need the, so the money actually has to be in the account of the person coming to school, as opposed to a sponsor's account. You need the money to be in your own personal account. And when you put it in your personal account, you're supposed to get a bank statement from the bank that shows that you have certain amount of money in your account. So the bank, the letter will basically read, this is to show that so person, your name of course, has so amount of money in his account. And yeah, that is all actually. Like for mine, all I just got was I got a bank statement and I got it stamped with an embassy. So I got mine from Access Bank and I got it stamped with the bank stamp to show that it was an official statement, and they stamped it and there was a date on it, and that was all. That was what I did. When I applied, I got rejected. Rejection. Yeah. So I got a mail back, I think after 2 days, that was telling me that the money in my account was insufficient. I was applying for a 1-year residence permit, and I think I had about 3 million naira in my account, and I was told that it was insufficient. Yeah, so I would say that you need about 110,682 Swedish krona. So that, let's just say roughly about 111,000 Swedish krona to show as proof of fund for a 1 year residence permit. So they don't give 1 year, they give at 13 months. So, well, 13 months is what is 1 year. So they give 13 months residence permit. So you need on 111,000 Swedish krona to show that as proof of fund, actually, and that translates to about 5.5 million Nigerian naira. Yeah, that's what you need to show to get a residence permit for 1 year. For you to apply for a residence permit card in Sweden, you need to have gotten admission and also paid your fees. So this shows they are serious, because most times admissions to international students are usually based on their fees. So you pay your fee as a confirmation that you are serious about the admission that you've gotten. So after you've paid your fees and your fees has been confirmed by the school, you know, that's when you can now start your applying for your residence permit card. So another thing is, if you pay your fees, don't fear. It takes like sometimes 1 to 2 weeks for it to actually reflect in the account. Yeah, it is crazy, because when I paid my school fees, I had to wait for like I think almost 2 weeks for it to get confirmed, and I was so scared because I literally got like the bank was saying that the money had gone, the school was saying they've not received it, and I was like, so where is the money? The money, it was like about 3.8 million naira, and I was like, no. Well, I mean, I was just there patiently waiting that I think the money arrived at the point. And when they arrived, the school sent the confirmation that my fees has been confirmed. Then I was now able to start my residence permit application. So another thing to put in mind is it takes a while for the money to reflect here in Sweden from Nigeria. So that's something, so don't be afraid when that happens for you. Yeah. I'm checking my book here. So, most schools give you an health insurance, an emergency health insurance that you can use in your application. So because you're a fee paying student, they have like an health insurance for you, so you don't need to worry about that for Sweden. I know some other countries you have to, but in Sweden you don't have to worry, because most schools actually give you an health insurance. So that's something to take note of.
So when I applied for my residence permit card, I applied on the 17th of July on a Friday, I think in the morning. And I got a message saying that, it was not really a rejection, yeah, but I got a message from the migration agency saying that they need me to put in additional information. So when I checked, the additional information was that the money in my account was insufficient and I had to put more money in to my account and send a new statement of account. So I did that same day, and I sent the new statement of result. And I sent in the new statement of account to them, and I had to book an appointment for biometrics and passports at the Nigerian embassy in Nigeria. And I did that on the 23rd of July. So I applied on the 17th of July. So I actually went to get a specific date so that we know how long it took. I first applied on the 17th of July, and I got a confirmation that same day, and I was asked to put in extra additional information, and I did that. And the following week, I got a mail saying that they've given me a control number and the details of my application. When I got that, the next thing is to register for biometrics and passport. It's not really a registration, it's more like booking an appointment with the embassy in your country. Yeah. So I did that on the 23rd of July. I actually did like the passport and biometrics on the 23rd of July. And I booked before that. And on the 6th of August, I got a mail that my card is ready and ready to be picked up. So this is like 2 weeks. Yeah, 17th of July to 6th of August is like two 2 weeks and a few days. So that's how long it took me for my application. So another thing I think people might have issues with is when it comes to payment for your residence permit card, like after you finish filling the form, you actually have a place where you can pay with your card. You can actually use your Nigerian card, or I use my Nigerian card to pay my GT Bank card, and there was no issues. So I'll say you can pay with your Nigerian card and there should be no issues with that. If you're having issues paying with your card, please clear your browser cache, then try it again. That issue, that was something I faced and I didn't know that solution was that simple. But yeah, that's actually my migration story. Not really migration story, but residence permit story.
This is migration's bracket. Yeah, this is the link here. If you actually visited and you are getting another language, just ensure to come to the top and click other language and click English. Yeah, I think it's not difficult. Apply for a permit. Yeah, apply for studies. For most masters and bachelor students, you actually, that is an higher education. Yeah. What again? Let's see. If you intend to study at an undergraduate or graduate level at university or university college, yep, apply. And like I said, your valid passport admitted to a full-time study in a Swedish university and be able to support yourself. This is your proof of fund. I've paid a possible tuition fee before you send your application, of course. And this is, yeah. Have or applied for a comprehensive health insurance policy. Most schools already do this for most international students, so you have less to worry about this. Apply and you do this. Yeah, username and password, of course. So I'll just show you my application. I saved my application, the details of my application. So I'll show you what it looks like and what you will be asked. I don't know if it has changed, but I did my application in 2020, so it might still be the same depending on when you're watching this video. So this is my application. This is what my application looks like. This is what all the information I had to put in, just so that you know you can get ready. Your passport details, a PDF of your passport, scan copy of your passport, your details, your contact information, the embassy contact abroad, that's which embassy are you applying to. Some regions have like 2 or 3 embassies, so you can choose between that. Types of studies, university or university college, at undergraduate or master's level. I put in the name of my program, my school, my school's acceptance letter, which is very important. Yeah. And the part where they will ask you about the educational institute contact person, what I did was I actually mailed. So what I did was I went to my school, I checked out my department and the person I was in charge, that is the head of department in my school, and I got his contact information and put his contact information there. And after doing that, I also sent him a personal mail introducing myself and what I'll be coming to school, that I'll be coming to school at Yong Shippen University in the new year. So I don't know, but I think, I don't know, I did the introduction just in case. Yep. Visiting for studies, I don't think you're supposed to put so much details here, but I actually just spoke about why I chose to study in Sweden, why my university, and why I chose the program I chose, of course. Current occupation, previous education, work experience, financial means. I think this is just asking you about if you have a scholarship, accommodation, because all of this also has to do with your proof of funds, show that you can support yourself when you're in school. So if you have somewhere to stay in Sweden, you actually naturally have less to show in terms of financial support. So yeah, for the other information part, what I did was my LinkedIn profile is really nice. I think it's really nice though. So I had an information about, I added my the link to my LinkedIn profile and also my work portfolio because I already have that. But if you don't have that, like I said, it's other information, so I don't think it's so important. Yep. Now this is what you actually be asked of. Yeah. So guys, thank you for, you know, staying with me throughout the end of this video. I hope you actually learned something. If you actually enjoyed this video and you actually want me to do more videos, please don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to leave a comment if you have any questions. Just let me know and I'll answer you. I hope you also enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to leave a thumbs up to encourage me. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. You know, I think there'll be more videos coming soon, so just let me know what issues you might be having, and yeah, we'll treat that in subsequent videos. Thank you guys. Bye. Cheers. See you later.